Now let's talk about the probably single most important part of this course, which are Google Analytics goals. In my work, I often see that goals are not installed, and therefore the data that Google Analytics is collecting is really useless because you can't tie it back to any outcome that you want to achieve. And when you look at metrics within Google Analytics, the question always should come up, so what? And goals really help you to tie the data that you see within Google Analytics back to the business goal or the outcome that you want to achieve with the website. And so I want to spend a little bit of time on goals at this point. And it's really revolving around the question, what does winning look like? Too often I hear the excuse, well, I can't really track my goals within Google Analytics. And once I dig deeper, I always find a metric that kind of resembles their goal, and I give them advice on how to track it and reinstall it. Now, I know that you are better than that to not make this excuse. I know that there are limitations in tracking goals within Google Analytics. We will look at the types in a second, but I want to really start from the top and give you a framework on how to quickly evaluate what goals you should be putting in place. And this is really a simplified view here. There are other models and frameworks out there that can give you a much better understanding of the goals that you should be tracking and how that ties back to the data that you're actually collecting. But just for sake of simplicity, I want to explain to you this four-step process. So first of all, the foundation of everything should be the business objectives. What is the preferred business outcome? Why is the business actually existing? Why are people paying money for the products? And how is this company actually making money? Once you have that settled, sometimes pretty clear that you can track that with Google Analytics, and these should then port over to what the purpose of the website actually is. So how does the website support the business objectives or make them even possible? What is really the purpose of the website, and what is the key actions that we want the user to take on the website? And then step three and four is really about how can we measure that? So there's this concept of macro and micro conversions. Macro conversions being these big goals that the end, these big measurable goals that tie directly back to my website purpose and business objectives. And sometimes, like on an online shop, this is very clear. You want the website to generate more sales. But then are also these side goals, these goals that lead up to a goal or are just not as important as the macro conversion. So, for example, a newsletter sign up is the first step to get people into your funnel, and later you upsell them on your website to a product. So the actual sale would be the macro conversion and the newsletter sign up, the micro conversion. Now, we don't really have to distinguish between macro and micro conversions at this point, because in Google Analytics, the goals are pretty straightforward to put in. But I just want to encourage you to think of all the possible goals that we could track within Google Analytics to evaluate the website performance. Now, let's take a look on how to install this within Google Analytics. Back in our demo account, we can find the goals section under the view finder here and under goals. And here we can start putting in a new goal. Now, the first step is to either choose a template or custom. Now, you can go with the templates if this is directly what you want, but it doesn't really do much for you. So we'll just go with custom and click on next step, and then we give our goal an appropriate name. And the name should always be something that the user actually did. So, for example, bought a product really makes it easier to later identify the goals when we choose them in our reports. Next, you can choose a slot, but otherwise, Google Analytics will choose the most recent one. And then it comes to the types. And to be honest with you, I don't really use the duration and page screen per session type because from my perspective, it doesn't really tell you anything about the outcome that the user took. So for example, if you stayed 5 minutes on your page, what does that really mean for your business outcomes? And the same goes for how many pages per session did he actually see on your page? What does that tell you about the user? So I rarely use these pages, only if it's really one of these micro conversions where we maybe saw in the data beforehand that a user that visited at least 5 pages is more likely to convert to the macro conversion. Then we'll put something like this in, but I rarely use this as macro conversions. The types that I mostly use are destinations. So if somebody actually goes to a very distinguished page, and that means he converted and he took the desired action, for example, went through the checkout and bought something, and he lands on the thank you page, that would be a destination goal. Or I choose the event goals. And event goals are something that we'll discuss in a later section of this course. Events are a little bit harder to put in place, but very, very powerful. As you might know, Google Analytics is mostly a page tracking tool. So with the current setup that we have installed, it will track all the pages that somebody visited, but not the interactions that they took. So did they click on the button? Did they fill out this form field and so on? And with the new technology of Ajax, for example, where the site doesn't reload when a user takes action, you really have to get familiar with event tracking, and you'll be later able to also put this into a goal.